Welcome to another inspiring message with Pastor Deborah Bell from Deo Gloria, South Africa, as she brings you a word from God.
I said to you that you didn't go through what you went through in 2010 for nothing. You didn't go through the transition that you've gone through, all that many of us are still going through, for nothing. Did God bring it on? No. But will God show you and teach you something through it that will help you, and not just you, but other people that come into your sphere of influence later on? Yes. Will you have more compassion because of what's happened to you? Yes. Will you have a deeper heart for people? Yes. We don't sit there counseling people based on our own experiences, because we can never experience everything everybody else can. Right? But it does help if there's things that we understand. And so tonight I want to challenge you to say to you, let's do what the word says. Wake up from our sleep. Don't allow the enemy to lie to you anymore about who you are and about the effects that you have in the lives and influence that you have in the lives of people. Don't think because you're still even in the healing process that you aren't going to be any good to anyone. You have a sound, and God will use that and take it for wherever God can use it, and take it for wherever you are at. Right at this moment in time, you can affect and change the kingdom. The problem with us is sometimes that we are so broken that we haven't given ourselves a real enough chance to heal before we get out there and go into all these ministries and let out all these amazing sounds. And sometimes the wrong sound comes out. And it's that sound that exhausts us, because we still have some healing to do. And so that's why we encourage this very vision of the church, which is for us to be saved, healed, and then made whole. We can't just go from being saved into wholeness. There's a form of wholeness, but there has to also be a time and a season of healing, although that's an ongoing thing in our life process. But you've had some things to process in 2010. Every one of you, it's been something else. But this is the year of God's favor. This is the year of being called Hephzibah. You are God's delight. And the reason God's given us that name collectively is so that individually we can go and understand what it means to be God's delight. In what way am I God's delight? Oh Lord, what is it that you see in me that I can begin to release that sound out of my spirit and into the atmosphere and to touch the lives of people? So that my passion is ignited, and that fire is ignited in me again. And then I'm not going to let the devil win and pull me down with everything that he's put across my path in 2010. Oh no, I'm not.
Amen.
I'm going to stand there and say, listen, I've got a son to bring to this earth. There is something in me that God has that is valuable. And it's not just for other people. Because when you find your sound, there's nothing more satisfying as a human being than living that out. Ministry is exhausting. I know that. More than maybe many. It's not easy because you're dealing with people. However, there's nothing more satisfying than being in the will of God and being in the ministry and the place that you are called to. Remember something. I said to you last week that when we talk about releasing the sound and changing the atmosphere and taking the new territory, we don't only start warring when we're in the new territory. We start before we get there. Like the example of the Garden of Gethsemane, that's where Jesus warred. Remember? And then at the cross, the victory was had.
Yeah.
Jesus didn't start warring at the cross. That's the place that Jesus said it was finished. That's where we had the victory. But the warring came before the time of the cross. And for you and I, very often, we don't take territory before we come to that next level of victory that God wants to take us to, because we haven't discovered what that sound is. And so the strong person, or strong man, as we know, Your worry is submitting. Sometimes it's just saying, Lord, I'm submitting this territory to you. I'm submitting this area of my life to you. Not warring for everything except in the spirit. And sometimes you and I are warring for physical territory. And we shouldn't be warring, we should be submitting. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Some of us, we say, but you know what, I've been warring and warring and warring and I'm so tired, I can't war anymore. But some of that warring is submission. Saying, Lord, you know what, I just can't do this. I need you to take control of it. I need to actually release that. I know I haven't spoken about control for a long time, but tonight I'm going to. We need to release, instead of war, the way we understand warring, we need to war by releasing in submission to the Lord. And then the Lord gives us the territory. But you have a sound to make. You have a sound to release that no one else can release. Don't let the Lord raise somebody up to make your sound. A sound that belongs to you. A sound that doesn't belong to anybody else. Because the devil's told you, you have no voice. You have no sound. You have nothing to offer. There is nothing you can do. Amen? We have a sound to make together. A perfect harmony. And a pitch that works together just like an orchestra. That's the army of God. Everything working in harmony. Everything coming in its perfect timing. Because with a song, it's not just about harmony, it's about timing, right?
Yeah.
And everything must be done in accordance with God's perfect timing. So what I want to just mention, just to finish off with, is to say that if we're going to move into a place where we are, it's our signature year, that means it's your signature year. It means there's a uniqueness to what God wants to show you about yourself, about your ministry, about your life, about how you can change the lives of others just by being who you are, just by letting that part of you come out. We have to be clear about what God is saying. We have to be clear about what God is saying. There's some voices that come into your head and they're not always God. Sometimes they're our own voices. And we need to make sure that we get the right kind of confirmation when we say something's from God. Amen? Now, we know that God will speak to us, but we've got to distinguish also when it comes to being a very prophetic church, right? And so even in prophecy, listen, I just want to remind you about something if I can, just to digress with this example. I mean, you'll know that Daniel and Joseph were probably the most profound dream interpreters ever that existed on planet Earth, right? They were the pros. If somebody wanted a dream interpreted, you would pay a lot of money to get Daniel or Joseph into a ministry. Amen? Probably not, but you know what I'm saying. And so they were amazing at interpreting the dreams of kings and everybody else, but not so good at interpreting their own. And so very often what we've got to remember is that the body of Christ has been designed so that we can depend on one another. So that we can rely on one another. Amen? That's part and parcel of it. And so we must be clear about what is prophetically for someone else and what is prophetically for us. Sometimes God's given you a prophetic voice, and you might have something to say and say, you know what, Pastor, this is for the church, when it might be for you first. And often it's for you. Amen? So we must just be clear about what God is saying and isn't saying. And you're not going to discover what your signature sound is unless you are hearkened to what God is saying to you in this season. Now let me tell you what other voice comes in. The other voice that comes in is called the voice of fear. This voice is the most prominent voice in every human being's mind. It shouldn't be, because we are more than conquerors. It shouldn't be, because we have the victory through Jesus Christ. It shouldn't be, because the Bible says we are overcomers through the blood of the Lamb, but it is. Because the spirit of fear is so silent that what it does is it comes up into our heads, and of course, a seed that is planted by the enemy comes to us and says, well, you know, you must be careful of this. And automatically, the faith seed starts dying and the fear seed starts growing. And the voice, the signal to Jesus gets cut off somewhere along the line. And never mind losing hope, we don't even have a vision for our lives anymore. We're just stuck in somewhere between a rock and a hard place, and that's where we stay. That's where we think we're meant to be. That's the justice of it. Listen, you and I don't live by karma. We live by the cross. We aren't meant to go into a place and be punished for our sins. When you're experiencing suffering on any dimension, it's not because God is cross with you. It's not because Jesus has got a plot against you because you weren't obedient. Listen, you've got to hear me, folks, because you can't believe. We smile, all of us. But do you want to know how many Christians believe that? That suffering has come upon their lives because of something they didn't do for God. Do you know what kind of distorted thinking that is? And it's not unusual thinking. Many Christians think like that. And that's why it's so important that we get to know the God that we serve. This is a God of love. Yes, God requires obedience. If we want to move into the fullness of God's blessing, if we want to move into our fullness of destiny and purpose and all those things, of course it requires obedience. But God doesn't bring a plague onto you. God doesn't, and I'm not saying God doesn't do that for different reasons with kings and governments, but not with. Do you know what I'm saying? It's not like you've done something and then God says, okay, right, I'm going to punish you. The cross has been given for you and I. And that's what I meant by producing fruit in keeping with repentance. If we just come to Jesus and say, Lord, just help me. I'm struggling to have faith in this time. I don't know what's going on with me. But keep submitting yourself to Jesus. Don't let the devil plant those seeds of fear that pull you from one cycle into another. And all you do is live a life of hopelessness instead of a life of passion. And being able to see so far out because God has touched your life with something. The thing that God wishes on you is the best. Love, a purpose, a life of hope, of joy, of peace, of goodness. Amen? So be clear about what God is saying. So the one thing is hear God's voice. The second thing is be clear about what God is saying. That's distinguishing between what is for you, what is for other people. Depend on each other.
You have been watching Pastor Deborah Bell from Deo Gloria, South Africa.